just a few minutes right here on CBS. We have 51 of the country's most beautiful young ladies competing for the Miss USA crown, and the winner will go to Acapulco, Mexico in July to represent our country in the Miss Universe pageant. And on the show with me tonight is our reigning Miss USA, Kim Tomes.
Good evening.
Kim and I have been saying all week that this year's contestants are the prettiest we've ever had in the Miss USA pageant.
Oh, they're gorgeous. I don't think I could pick 10 winners, let alone one.
I'll bet the judges feel the same way. Our guest star tonight is the very talented Jack Jones.
Thank you, Bob. I've just been talking with some of the girls backstage, and boy, are they excited.
Well, they should be, because one of them is about to become an overnight celebrity. Stay tuned, and we'll be right back with all of the beauty of the Miss USA pageant on CBS Live.
This is CBS.
USA Beauty Pageant.
Charleston.
With contestants from 50 states and the District of Columbia.
Charleston.
Tonight's winner will receive more than $75,000 in cash and prizes.
Charleston.
And in July, she'll compete with beauties from 80 countries in the Miss Universe Pageant in Mexico.
Charleston.
And now, led by our reigning queen, Kim Tomes, Miss USA of 1977, here are the most beautiful young ladies in the USA.
USA escorts
from the Military College of South Carolina, the Citadel Marching Band and Chorale. Miss Helen O'Connell. Tonight's special guest star, Jack Jones. And your master of ceremonies, Bob Barker.
USA.
The Miss USA Beauty Pageant is being brought to you by Tide. Women who count on cleaning put their trust in Tide. And by Head & Shoulders, the shampoo that's strong against dandruff, gentle on your hair. And by Crest, the cavity fighter.
Every day at Crest, we get letters from kids asking about teeth.
Grandma, hey, Grandma, Crest answered my letter.
I told you they would.
I want to know more about teeth than anybody in my school. See, these? They're incisors. That's what it says in my letter.
That must be, then.
They're for cutting.
Is that so?
And you know how many teeth you have?
How many teeth do I have?
This says kids my age have 20, but when I get older, I'm going to have 32.
You will if you take care of them.
Well, Crest has fluoride. That's the best thing for teeth.
If you brush.
Write to Crest, Cincinnati, Ohio, if you or your kids would like to know more about teeth. After all, the more you know about teeth, the more you'll appreciate Crest.
On the top, I brush back and forth. On the bottom, I wiggle it.
You certainly are a smart one.
Crest is
Ladies and gentlemen, here again is your host, Bob Barker.
The 27th annual Miss USA Beauty Pageant, and the key word is beauty, because we have 51 absolutely beautiful contestants competing for the Miss USA title, and we're coming to you live from Charleston, South Carolina, one of the most beautiful cities in the USA. It is indeed. It's all of that. Last year, we brought the pageant to Charleston for the first time, and the people were so warm and so friendly, and their hospitality was so gracious that this year, we all came back for more. We did indeed, and we're getting it. I'd have come back just to have some more of your she-crab soup, myself. Our reigning queen, Kim Tomes, will crown tonight's winner, and that young lady will receive more cash awards and prizes than any Miss USA in history. And she'll go on to represent our country in July at the Miss Universe pageant in the exciting city of Acapulco, Mexico. The Mexican contingent is right over here. We have representatives from all 50 states and the District of Columbia, and they'd like to meet you and greet you right now. So get ready to cheer for your favorite. Here are the 1978 Miss USA delegates in the traditional parade of states. Miss Alabama.
Hello, I'm Eva Jo Stansel from Birmingham.
Miss Alaska.
Greetings from Anchorage. I'm Barbara Samuelson.
Miss Arizona.
Hi, I'm Jackie Crutchfield from Phoenix, Arizona.
Miss Arkansas.
Good evening. I'm Donna Funderburk from El Dorado.
Miss California.
Good evening. I'm Donna Adrian from Los Angeles, California.
Miss Colorado.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Linda Potestio from Pueblo.
Miss Connecticut.
U.S. State from Hartford. I'm Martha Sabo.
Miss Delaware.
Hi, I'm Donna Lewis from Newcastle.
Miss District of Columbia.
Hello. From Washington, D.C.
Miss Florida.
Good evening. I'm April Shaw from Lakeland, Florida.
Miss Georgia.
Good evening. I'm Marina Matthews from Marietta.
Miss Hawaii.
Aloha. I'm Judy Anderson from Honolulu.
Miss Idaho.
Hello. I'm Suzette Sanford from Pocatello, Idaho.
Miss Illinois.
Good evening. Suzanne Pache from Lombard.
Miss Indiana.
Hello. I'm Jamie Beaker from Jasper, Indiana.
Miss Iowa.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Michelle Daly from West Des Moines.
Miss Kansas.
Hi, everyone. I'm Diddy Bell from Wichita.
Miss Kentucky.
Hello, I'm Linda Woodger from Louisville.
Miss Louisiana.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Tawny Haynes from Baton Rouge.
Miss Maine.
Good evening. I'm Catherine LeDoux from Portland.
Miss Maryland.
Hi, I'm Rhonda Cook from Brookville.
Miss Massachusetts.
Hello, I'm Diane Pollard from Hamilton.
Miss Michigan.
Hello, my name is April Patrick, and I'm from Detroit.
Miss Minnesota.
Mississippi.
Good evening, I'm Wanda Gatlin from Oxford.
Missouri.
Good evening, I'm Paula Taylor from Columbia.
Miss Montana.
Good evening, I'm Susan Ripley and I'm from Billings.
Miss Nebraska.
Hi, I'm Sherry Reimers from Millard.
Miss Nevada.
Hi everyone, my name is Rochelle Jameson, I'm from Las Vegas.
Miss New Hampshire.
Good evening, I'm Barbara Jean Miller from Goffstown.
Miss New Jersey.
Good evening, my name is Cheryl Ann Hohen and I'm from Clark.
Miss New Mexico.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Marlene Darling from Las Cruces.
Miss New York.
Hello, I'm Darlene Javits from Plainview.
Miss North Carolina.
Good evening, I'm Kathy Norman from Charlotte.
Miss North Dakota.
Good evening, everyone, I'm Trace Olson from Fargo.
Miss Ohio.
Hello, everyone, I'm Sheila Anderson from Cincinnati.
Miss Oklahoma.
Hi, I'm Nancy Lippold, and I'm from Norman.
Miss Oregon.
Hello, I'm Julie Heater from Salem.
Miss Pennsylvania.
Good evening, I'm Sandy Dow from Latrobe.
Miss Rhode Island.
Good evening, my name is Sharon Lee McGarry, and I'm from Warwick.
Miss South Carolina. Miss South Dakota.
Hello, I'm Nadine Oppo from Sioux Falls.
Miss Tennessee.
Hello, I'm Susanna Timberlake from Chattanooga.
Miss Texas.
Good evening, I'm Barbara Horan from Dallas.
Miss Utah.
Hi, I'm Margo Finn from Salt Lake City.
Miss Vermont.
Hi, everyone, I'm Nancy Wurzbicki from Rutland.
Miss Virginia.
Good evening, everyone, I'm Robin Shadle from Springfield.
Miss Washington.
Good evening, I'm Barbara Boga from Seattle, Washington.
Miss West Virginia.
Hi, I'm Jessica Davis from Huntington.
Miss Wisconsin.
Hi, I'm Cynthia Paulson from Eau Claire.
Miss Wyoming.
Hello, I'm Catherine Slinger from Grey Bull.
And there are the 51 beautiful candidates for Miss USA of 1978. Tonight's very first award goes to Miss Amity, the young lady voted most popular and friendly by her fellow contestants. And this year, Miss Amity will receive an all-expenses-paid trip to the Miss Universe pageant in Acapulco. Here to tell us the name of the winner is our reigning Miss USA, Kim Tomes. Tell us, Kim Tomes, Miss USA of 1977, who is Miss Amity?
Miss Amity is Miss Vermont.
Miss Vermont. Right here in the corner. Now you have the Miss Amity Award to go along with your speech. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, everybody. I think for the first time in my life, I'm speechless.
Well, is there anything at all you'd like to say to the girls who voted you Miss Amity?
I'd just like to thank them all, and I just feel so proud to have this award, because just important to winning the crown of Miss USA is the award of Amity. Thank you, everyone.
Well said. Congratulations, Miss Amity.
Share it with me. There are more than 3,000 people with me in the Gilliard Auditorium tonight, but we've saved the best seat in the house for you. This year we have some of the most beautiful contestants I've ever seen in the Miss USA pageant, I swear. So it's going to be very exciting to see which 12 are chosen to be semifinalists, which 5 become finalists, and which one is named Miss USA of 1978. People root for the representative of their state, but remember, there's nothing wrong with choosing the lady you think is the most beautiful and rooting for her no matter where she comes from. After all, that's exactly what the judges do. And now you're about to see the most sensational swimsuit event you've ever seen. We'll return right after this message from Head and Shoulders.
You can take many fascinating tours of Charleston and its surroundings, but the one we're going to take you on now is unique, because along the way, you will see all 51 of our state queens in a dazzling designer collection of Catalina swimsuit fashions. We took our cameras all over Charleston, and the result is the prettiest sightseeing tour available anywhere in the USA. This replica of a 17th century trading ship is anchored at Charlestown Landing, the site of the first permanent English-speaking settlement in South Carolina. But no ship in history ever had a crew as beautiful as this one. Here are Miss Arkansas and Miss Alabama. Donna Funderburk and Eva Jo Stanson. Miss District of Columbia and Miss Delaware. Wanda Kleinman and Donna Lewis. Miss Georgia and Miss Florida. Linda Matthews and April Shaw. Miss Louisiana and Miss Kentucky. Tawny Marie Haynes and Linda Woodruff. Miss Mississippi and Miss Maryland. Wanda Gatlin, Wanda Cope. This magnificent tree is called Angel Oak. It's a 1,400-year-old live oak, and it's on John's Island, just 15 miles outside of Charleston. And here are Miss Connecticut and Miss Maine. Martha Zabel and Catherine Ledoux. Miss Massachusetts, Miss New Hampshire, and Miss New Jersey. Diane Pollard, Barbara Miller, and Cheryl Ann Hohen. Miss Pennsylvania and Miss New York. Sandy Dell and Darlene Javits. Miss Rhode Island and Miss Vermont. Sharon Lee McGarry and Nancy Wurzbicki. Miss North Carolina, Miss South Carolina, and Miss Tennessee. Catherine Ann Norman. Catherine Three. And Susanna Timberlake. Miss Virginia and Miss West Virginia. Robin Lee Shadle and Debbie Davis. In World War II, the aircraft carrier Yorktown was known as the Fighting Lady. Today, it stands proudly at Patriots Point in Charleston. It's a naval and maritime museum that's visited by tourists from all over the world every year. Now, if you can read semaphore flags, you know that today, the most important message is Miss USA. Here are Miss Indiana and Miss Illinois. Jamie Beaker and Suzanne Fichet. Miss Kansas and Miss Iowa. Mary Bell and Michelle Daly. Miss Minnesota and Miss Michigan. Danny Gold and April Patrick. Miss Nebraska and Miss Missouri. Sherry Reimers and Paula Taylor. Miss Ohio and Miss North Dakota. Sheila Anderson and Teresa Olson. Miss Wisconsin and Miss South Dakota. Cynthia Paulson and Nadine Oppold. Seabrook Island is a beautiful resort where the Miss USA contestants spend a day in the sun. At Seabrook, you can swim, sail, play tennis and golf, ride a Jeep along 3.5 miles of beach, or just enjoy the scenery. Like Miss Arizona, Miss California, and Miss Idaho. Jackie Crutchfield, Donna Adrian, and Suzette Sanford. Miss Montana and Miss Colorado. Suzanne Riplett and Linda Potestio. Miss Nevada and Miss New Mexico. Don Jameson and Marlena Garland. Seabrook Island is right on the ocean, but these ladies decided to model their swimsuits at the poolside. Here are Miss Oregon and Miss Oklahoma. Julianne Heater and Nancy Lippold. Miss Utah and Miss Texas. Margot Flynn and Barbara Jo Horan. Miss Washington and Miss Wyoming. Barbara Ann Bogar and Catherine Flitner. Miss Alaska and Miss Hawaii. Barbara Samuelson and Judy Anderson. And here are all all 51 Miss USA contestants on the bridge at Magnolia Plantation and Gardens, waving to all the people of Charleston who have provided such a wonderful week of happy memories.
Grand and the red rose vine is clinging to the gate. What's a little bit south of North Carolina? You know it, South Carolina and the great city of Charleston. I'm sure you can tell from that spectacular swimsuit fashion show that Charleston is rich in history as well as natural beauty. There are old plantations, elegant 18th century homes, and many historic streets and landmarks. Now, during the show tonight, some former Miss USA winners are going to take you to a few of these famous places so that you can see them firsthand. Then I think you'll understand why we're all so happy to be back here with the Miss USA pageant again. And now, let's watch a woman who will not be talked out of using a product she believes in.
Could you get this clean?
Yes, sir.
On Tuesday night of this week, our judges saw all 51 of the Miss USA contestants for the first time, and they judged them in swimsuit and evening gown competitions. Then on Thursday and Friday, each judge had a personal interview with every one of the candidates. Now, may I have that list, please? At you. The ballots from these important preliminaries were tabulated by Ernst & Ernst, one of the country's leading accounting firms, and now we're going to learn which 12 contestants had the highest total scores. These 12 young ladies will be tonight's semifinalists. Now, before I announce the names of our semifinalists, let's bring back all of our beautiful state winners in outfits of Celanese Fortrell by Patty O'Neill. Here are the 51 candidates for Miss USA of 1978. These contestants do not know which 12 names are on this card. In fact, the judges don't know either because they mark their ballots individually without consulting one another. Good luck to all of you. Now, girls, I want you to understand that these names are not in alphabetical order. They are not in any order. I will simply read them at random. Here we go. The 12 semifinalists for Miss USA of 1978. First name, Miss Florida. Next name on the list is Miss Indiana. Finalist number three is Miss Alaska. And look out, folks, here comes Miss Oklahoma. West for Miss California. And we're halfway there now. Number six is Miss Virginia. Of semifinalists is Miss Texas. And I think you're going to be happy with Miss Utah. Next, Miss Pennsylvania. And now, Miss Hawaii. Only two more names on the list of 12, only two, and one of them is Miss New Mexico. Now we're down to that last name. There is only one more girl who has a chance to become Miss USA of 1978, and that girl is Miss Massachusetts. Semi-finalists. One of them will become Miss USA.
Here, and I thought we'd tell you a little bit about them. Let's look at each girl as I tell you a little bit about each one of them, shall we? All right. Representing Indiana, 24-year-old Jamie Beaker. Jamie graduated from Stevens College and now works as an interior designer. Nancy Lynn Lippold is Miss Oklahoma. Nancy's 21 years old and a junior at the University of Oklahoma, where she studies acting and directing. Miss Virginia is 22 years old. Her name is Robin Lee Robin. She's a graphic designer and attends the University of Virginia. She's working on her master's degree. Margot Flynn is Miss Utah. She's 18 years old and works as a secretary in a bank. 20-year-old Judy Anderson is Miss Hawaii. She studied fashion design at Millbrook College and is now an airline stewardess. Representing Massachusetts is Diane Pollard. She's 20 years old and a professional model. Marlena Garland is Miss New Mexico. Marlena is 22 years old and a senior at New Mexico State University studying nutrition. Miss Pennsylvania's 22-year-old Sandy Dell. Now, Sandy's a graduate of Duquesne University and also a professional model. Miss Texas is Barbara Horan. She's 21 years old and studying broadcast journalism at Southern Methodist University. Miss California is 21-year-old Donna Lynn Adrian. Donna is a student at UCLA where she's majoring in communications. Representing Alaska is Barbara Samuelson. She's a 23-year-old registered nurse from Anchorage. And 22-year-old April Shaw is Miss Florida. Now, she's a graduate of Weber College and is the fashion coordinator for two department stores. How about that? Bob Barker is going to talk to each of the semifinalists in just a few moments, and that's a good time for you to try to pick out the winner before the judges do. We will return after this message from Joy.
The judges have chosen 12 semifinalists, and now, as they say on another very, very, very popular program, Miss Indiana, come on down. Miss Indiana is Jamie Beaker. She lives in Indianapolis, and you are an interior designer for a business equipment company, aren't you?
Yes, I'm the head designer there.
Oh, good for you. How many designers are there?
One, myself.
How do you get along with the staff?
Real well. I'm the only woman there.
What does an interior designer for an equipment company do, Jamie?
I design office layouts. I go in and plan all the interiors and decide what goes where and work with the people and see what needs they have.
It's just as if you were an interior designer or an interior decorator for a house. I mean, you decorate offices.
Same idea.
Mm-hmm. Sounds interesting. Now, many of the girls here at the pageant have relatives or friends or friendly relatives here during the week, don't they?
Yes.
And your mother's here, isn't she?
Yes.
And she said that you have a very special relative who is right out there watching. Now, who is that?
That's my 90-year-old grandfather who's in the Good Samaritan home. And all the people in Jasper at the Good Samaritan home all took naps this afternoon so they could stay up late to watch this.
I think that's marvelous. I think that's great. Grandpa, I want you and all your buddies to know, you just hang in there. You only have an hour and a half to go. You know, in that same vein, Miss Mississippi asked me if she were not among the 12 semifinalists to be sure and say hello to Cookie, who is her 89-year-old great-grandmother, and she'll be watching if there's no bingo game. But she wouldn't let a bingo game interfere. Well, Miss Indiana, I'll be seeing you on Memorial Day weekend in Indiana. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yes. Miss Oklahoma, would you come out and say hello to the very nice audience here in Charleston and all over the U.S. of A.? Miss Oklahoma is Nancy Lippold, and you're studying drama at the University of Oklahoma.
Yes, sir.
And I believe that you recently had a part in Big Hawaii.
Yes, I played a typhoid victim.
A typhoid victim?
Yes, life and death situation, as my acting teacher says.
How do you play a typhoid victim? What did you do to?
I had to do a lot of sensory recall, which means I had to study what typhoid was, and I found out that you had chills, fever, and a lot of nausea.
Chills,
fever, and nausea.
It sounds like a rehearsal for the pageant, actually, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
Now, your chaperone has been bragging on you. She says that she says you're one of the most obedient girls here. And I was curious to know, were your parents or are your parents strict with you?
Well, let me say this. My father's in the U.S. Marine Corps, and he used to be the commanding officer of the brig at Camp Lejeune.
Oh, he did?
Yes, he did.
And a little of that rubbed off on you.
Oh, a little bit.
I heard a boo from the Citadel Cadets right over here just then. Well, how about the Marines? Do you date Marines?
No, I haven't ever dated a Marine.
They're probably scared to death to get near you.
Who knows? I don't know.
You have described yourself in your bio as a very busy girl.
Yes,
What do you do? What's an average day like?
Oh, well, let's see. I do a lot of hiking, and I raise plants, and I collect shells, and I do macrame a little bit. I'm learning how to do that. I'm learning how to play racquetball. I'm in drama, of course, at the theater almost 24 hours a day, it seems like. And I keep myself fairly busy.
It sounds as if you came to Charleston for a rest.
Yeah, well, it's been just about the same as my schedule.
Well, it's a pleasure to have you here. Now, as your daddy might say, about face, forward, march. They told it very well, don't you think? How about you, Miss Virginia? Will you come down here to me? Miss Virginia is Robin Lee Shadel. She lives in Springfield, and Massachusetts is your roommate.
Yes, she is.
So a most unusual thing has occurred here, hasn't it? Two roommates, both among the 12 semifinalists.
Oh, it's great. I'm so happy for
yes.
her.
Yes. Have you and Massachusetts, well, I know you have. Have you discussed the possibilities even one of you being one of the semifinalists?
Yes, we've talked about it.
How did you feel? Now, be honest. Did you think when you came here, I do have a good chance, or I hope I have a chance, or I don't have a chance? How'd you feel?
It was more like, I hope I have a chance.
How did Massachusetts feel?
Oh, I think she felt the same way.
Yeah. That must be a lucky room. Tell me your room number, not the hotel. Not the hotel. I don't want traffic jams in Charleston. But what's your room number?
506.
506. Now, if you don't have a lucky number there at home, 506 could work for you. I was reading the names of the states here, and when in the parade of states, when you came out, you were wearing the traditional naval officer's blouse. Miss Virginia always wears this.
Oh, always.
And
yes.
It was lovely on you. But only tonight, I found out that Miss Virginia always wears the same blouse for 14 years. They've been wearing, and you're not always the same size. How do you do this?
Well, we adjust it. And inside, there are darts and all kinds of little seam adjustments. And I think I have by far the smallest neck of any Miss Virginia. Hey, I had to cut my uniform this time.
Are there messages in there like, keep smiling and my feet hurt when we break for lunch?
No messages, no.
Someone said that you had to shorten it.
Yes, I did.
How tall are you?
5'7".
Well, we better not have a Miss Virginia any taller than 5'7", or we're in serious trouble around here, right?
Or a fatter neck.
Well, if you win, maybe with your $10,000, you can buy another blouse.
Okay,
thank you, Miss Virginia. Miss Utah, I want to talk with you. Miss Utah here is Margot Flynn. She lives in Salt Lake City, and you are a secretary at a bank.
At Valley Bank.
Why did you decide to go to work at Valley Bank?
Well, I had an exclusive interview with the assistant director of the personnel department, and she interviewed me, and we talked it over. And since she was my mother, she decided to hire me.
What's your job? What do you do as a secretary at the bank?
I'm the loan secretary for three officers.
And do you have anything to do with making the loans?
No, I process the loans, so...
Only when after they've been approved by the officers. Now, do you have a big family? Your mother is there. Do you have brothers or sisters?
Yes, I have two brothers, 15 and 16, and my older sister is 22.
What are their names?
15-year-old is Errol Flynn, and 16-year-old...
Errol Flynn? Errol Flynn is your brother?
My little brother.
You got it made with a mother who's an officer in a bank, and Errol Flynn is a brother.
Yes. He keeps me on my toes, so.
Did he give you any advice for the pageant?
Yes, both Rodney and Errol gave me advice, you know, stand up straight, be self-confident.
Well, with Errol Flynn as a coach, you ought to do very well here. Is Errol here with you?
Yes, he is.
Is he?
Mm-hmm.
You say he's 15?
Uh-huh.
Has he made much of an impression on these girls during rehearsal?
Well, a couple of the contestants' younger sisters have come up to me and, wow, you know, your little brothers or something.
That's
else.
Errol Flynn, all right. Yeah.
All right.
Thank you, Miss Utah.
You.
Would you come out here to me now, Miss Hawaii? Miss Hawaii is Judy Anderson, and she lives in Honolulu. And you're a busy girl. You do some modeling. Your mother is a designer, isn't she?
That's right.
And you model for her.
Mm-hmm.
And you are also a stewardess for Hawaiian Airlines.
That's right.
And, of course, that's the airline that flies between the islands. It must be an exciting job.
Yes, it's very exciting. The longest trip is 40 minutes. It's a lot of fun, though.
Well, after seeing them all and many times, what's your favorite island?
I'd say Maui.
Mm-hmm. Why?
Well, it's the greenest. We have a house there, and we visit quite often. And I just enjoy it because there's a lot of beach and a lot of privacy.
Will they be watching tonight?
Of course.
Barker to pilot, get your eyes off the television set and back on the instruments. The passengers are uneasy. Mm. Now, there are all sorts of superstitions over there.
That's
Is
right.
there one that you believe in?
Well, I do. I believe there's a god everyone believes about, and her name is Peli, Madame Peli. And if you don't believe in her, then she can do bad things to you, like make a volcano erupt over your house and you'll get a tidal wave real quick. So.
What does she look like?
Well, everyone has their own views of what she looks like. I think she looks like a big, huge, fiery mountain, you know, just like a volcano. She comes out and she's like a spirit.
Mm. But she can take any form.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Could she be one of the contestants?
No.
I was just thinking, if she should be one of the contestants and one that wasn't a semi-finalist, I hope you judges have your accident insurance paid up, you know, if she's as bad as this. Thank you, Miss Hawaii. Miss Massachusetts, let's talk with you. Miss Massachusetts here is Diane Pollard from Hamilton, and you are the other half of the winning combo of Massachusetts and Virginia.
That's right.
And I guess this is a testimonial to jogging, actually, isn't it? Haven't both of you been jogging every morning?
Yeah, we do. We get up on the days that our schedule isn't too heavy here, and we jog around the motel, and our chaperone watches us from the window, as always.
From the window?
Well, sometimes she comes outside and makes sure that, you know, we come around. She times us.
Your figures are getting better and better, and her eyesight is improving, huh?
Yes.
What if she should be looking out this window and one of these Citadel cadets jogs out of a bush after you? What would she do? She could never get out there, could she?
She'd chase after us, I'm sure.
She's a busy chaperone.
Yes, she is.
Now, you are a part-time hostess at a restaurant called Natalie's.
That's right.
Are they watching?
Well, it's an Italian restaurant. Saturday nights are very busy there. They have a band that plays in the lounge, and there is a television, but they can't put it on. So what they're doing is the employees brought in a TV, and they've got it back in the kitchen, probably watching me right now.
Are they?
And they're sneaking in on their breaks.
If you are a patron waiting for service at Natalie's, a commercial is coming up very quickly here, and you may get your dinner. Thank you, Miss Massachusetts.
Thank you.
Yeah. Those are the first six of our 12 semifinalists for 1978.
Mentioned earlier that some of the beautiful Miss USA winners from past years are with us in Charleston this week, and like all of us, they fell in love with the city. We asked them if they would show you some of the interesting sights they've seen, and throughout the show, there'll be roving reporters bringing us some lively 30-second on-location reports. Now, here's the first of our former queens, Summer Bartholomew, Miss USA of 1975 at Boone Hall Plantation.
Boone Hall was originally a cotton plantation. In the early days, the 17,000-acre plantation had more than a dozen buildings, including a gin house. I thought that had something to do with moonshiners, until I was told that a gin house was a place where cotton was processed. The beautiful mansion itself has been very carefully preserved, inside and out. And just a walk around the grounds instantly puts you back in beautiful 18th-century Charleston. And now in beautiful 20th century Charleston, this is Summer Bartholomew at Boone Hall Plantation. Now back to you, Helen.
Thank you, Summer. What a beautiful setting for such a beautiful lady. Now let's hear this message about Sure antiperspirant spray.
We're back with our Miss USA semifinalists, and now we are about to meet Miss Florida. Come right out here with me, will you please, Miss Florida? She is April Shaw. April lives in Lakeland. And you are a fashion coordinator for two Sears stores, one in Winter Haven and one in Lakeland, right?
Yes. And we didn't think we could say Sears over the air, so all my Sears people told me to say that I'm a fashion coordinator where America shops. Did you get that?
They got that. They're also going to get the bill for that. What I was about to ask you, though, is this a problem for you, getting back and forth from Winter Haven and between Winter Haven and Lakeland?
Well, I'm a little accident prone.
Have you had some accidents?
Yes.
How many accidents have you had?
Well, about four or five.
Have you really?
Four or five, yeah.
And what sort of accidents have they been? What are some?
Well, I never hit anything moving. Never.
You don't?
Never. It's always houses or fire hydrants. Or one time I had Winnie the Pooh costume in my trunk and I was backing up. And I hit a car, but it was parked. And locked the plumbing system out of a home one time. Went through a lady's front porch and invited myself to dinner with my car.
Where was the lady?
Eating breakfast on her porch.
At the time?
I'm really not that bad. Yes.
But you have had all of these accidents.
Yes. My father used to be in the car business until he couldn't keep me supplied with cars, so he's doing something else.
What does the rest of the family do?
My sister's a nurse.
Well, that figures the way you drive.
Yes. And my father is now a senior buyer for the International Minerals and Chemicals Corporation.
We should point out to the good people of Charleston that her chaperone is doing all the driving while you're here, doesn't she?
She wouldn't give me those keys for anything.
I have a very dangerous assignment for you. Now, I want you to walk back to your place there. But as you do, Miss Alaska is going to start out to me. And I do not want any head-on collisions, okay? There you go, Miss Florida. Miss Alaska out here. This is Barbara Samuelson, and she lives in Anchorage. And I guess that actually life began for you with a beauty pageant, didn't it?
It seemed to, Bob.
Tell them this story. I think it's very interesting.
All right. When my mother was ready to have me, They had to call the doctor from the audience at the Miss Alaska pageant. So they dragged him out, and I was born while Miss Alaska was being crowned. So he spanked me, and he predicted I would be Miss Alaska 73.
Of 73?
73, but I figure better late than never.
Better late than never, right. Yes. Well, it could be happening again. Miss USA of 1996 could be being born at this very moment.
That'd be great.
Is there a doctor in the house? If that's happening. Now, Miss Alaska, you are a registered nurse.
Yes, sir.
But before you start lining up, gentlemen, to start having illnesses of different kinds, what does your father do?
My father's a commercial fisherman. He's also a judo instructor.
And your brother is into judo?
Yes, he made the USA judo team. He toured Red China and Korea, and he had the best record of the team with only one loss.
This gentleman thought he had a fever until he heard about that. Thank you very much, Miss Alaska. Miss California, let you and I talk. Miss California here is Donna Adrian, and Donna lives in Los Angeles, and a typical... And so does someone else live in Los Angeles. Typical California girl, blue eyes, blonde hair, and...
One correction, they're green.
Are they green? Well, that's right.
You haven't been staring into my eyes, I can tell.
My dear, we can correct that. But you have been having a marvelous time here, haven't you?
That's for sure.
Every time
I busy.
See you, you're talking with a group of girls, and most of them, many of them I have talked with, you have invited out to California to be your house guest.
I'm proud of it, and I enjoyed all the girls.
Do you know, can you name the states that you have invited to California to be your house guest?
Well, shall I go from A to W or from W to A?
Well, who have you actually invited?
Well, starting with my roommate, Wisconsin and Wyoming and Vermont, and from the A's, I could start at Alaska and Alabama and work all the way through the alphabet.
What about Tennessee?
Tennessee, definitely. She won Miss Pixable with $500, and if she doesn't come, she's got no excuse.
She wants to visit her, but she wants you to have money if you come out there, you see.
Well,
thank you, Miss California.
Thank you.
Miss Texas? You'd never know it to look at her, but Barbara Horan here of Dallas has the reputation of being the sweet tooth in the pageant, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Now, how have you earned this?
Well, since I've been here, I've eaten a chocolate cake and a half, and several dozen cookies, and many other things. I don't think I should go into it.
Well, do you eat when you're happy? Do you eat when you're sad? Do you eat when you're nervous?
I eat when I'm happy, and I'm proud to say that here in Charleston, I've gained 5 pounds.
Well, that speaks very well of the city of Charleston, and she must be having fun here.
Yes, I am.
Now, you are studying for a job in television, are you not?
Yes, I am.
How would you like my job?
Give me the mic.
I think she means this. Good. Next contestant, please. Miss Pennsylvania. Goodbye, Miss Pennsylvania. You sounded as if you were sincere. Miss Pennsylvania is Sandy Dell. She's from Latrobe, Pennsylvania. And I have heard rumors about a rather unusual pet that you have. Are the rumors true? What is your pet?
I have 3 pets. I have a dog, I have a Cuban tree frog, and I have a water dragon, which is a lizard about 2 feet long, spines down his back, and he's tame.
Is this the famous Godzilla I've heard about?
That's Godzilla.
And you take him with you, I understand, when you go shopping?
Oh, he goes shopping with me. Well, he lives in my bedroom, so he's, you know, he runs around my bedroom all day, and he'll watch television with me.
Does he like Price is Right?
Oh, that's his favorite show.
It's a smart, what did you say he is?
A water dragon.
It's a smart water dragon, yeah. Do you take him on dates?
Well, I've tried, but no.
What happened?
The guys always say it's either him or me, so.
At least you're going out with pretty bright guys. Do you have him here with you?
My lizard? No. My director said if I brought my lizard along, my roommate, who is Miss Vermont, would probably walk in the room and say, I'm not living in this zoo.
She might be right about that. Thank you, Miss Pennsylvania. Miss New Mexico. This is Marlena Garland. Marlena is from Las Cruces, Mexico.
New Mexico.
I'm in New Mexico, I beg your pardon. And you're... Family's hobby is genealogy, I hear.
That's correct.
And what have you learned about yourselves with the study of genealogy?
Do I dare say it here?
Well, I don't know. What is it?
My distant cousin is Ulysses S. Grant.
Do you hear that silence? Yes. This is the girl. Didn't you give some moccasins to Mayor Riley?
Yes, I did.
Those back. You may have to sneak out of South Carolina. Which side of the family are you related to General Grant? On your mother's side?
Mm-hmm.
On her father's side of the family, she is related to General Robert E. Lee. Don't say anything. You are. Robert E. Lee, Nathan Bedford Forrest, Stonewall Jackson, and I think General Longstreet, right?
You're getting close.
Yes, just keep talking until we get out of town. Thank you, Miss New Mexico. And now you've met them all, our 12 semifinalists for the title of Miss USA.
Well, you've seen all of tonight's semifinalists in the swimsuit competition in just a few minutes. Now it's time to visit another of Charleston's most historic places, and waiting to tell you all about it is Miss USA of 1974, Karen Morrison.
Thank you, Helen. I'm standing in the Charleston City Council meeting room, where the walls are covered with paintings of famous statesmen. Here's the famous second painting of George Washington by John Trumbull. His first painting of Washington was rejected by the Charleston City Fathers, and the artist was so angry, he painted several mistakes in this one. For instance, Washington's coat is buttoned backwards. But Trumbull really got his revenge when he painted Washington's horse, because he gave more prominence to the horse's posterior than to his head. I doubt if they laughed about it way back then. Now back to you, Helen.
Thank you, Karen. A little later in the show, Debbie Shelton, Miss USA of 1970, is going to take us to the oldest theater in America, right here in Charleston. We will return after this message about crests.
You've met our 12 semi-finalists, and while they're getting ready for tonight's swimsuit competition, I have the pleasure of introducing our special guest star. You've seen him on television many, many times, and music lovers everywhere regard him as one of the country's finest song stylists. In addition to all his talent, he happens to be a very nice guy. Here is Jack Jones.
And the sorrow we did what we had to do. And I won't forget what I did for love.
beautiful semi-finalists are now going to compete in one of the most important pageant events, the swimsuit competition. Earlier in the show, you saw all of the contestants in a variety of Catalina fashion swimsuits. This time, the girls will be wearing identical suits, and I'll bet they'll look perfect in every one of them. Now, as they come out, I want you to respond just as you have been responding, audience. Show us which ones you like the most. Of course, our judges, they'll be tabulating their ballots over here, getting ready to select five finalists. Now, here is the Miss USA Swimsuit Competition for 1978. Miss Florida.
Is a blonde with blue eyes. She weighs 128 pounds and is 5'8½" tall.
Miss Indiana.
Blonde-haired, green-eyed Jamie is 24 years old. She weighs 120 pounds and she's 5'8" tall.
Miss Alaska.
Barbara's 5'10" tall and weighs 128 pounds. Her hair is black, her eyes are brown, and she's 23 years old.
Miss Oklahoma.
Blonde with brown eyes. She's 21 years old, weighs 115 pounds, and is 5'7½" tall.
Miss California.
Donna is 21 years old. She is a blonde with green eyes and is 5'10½" tall and weighs 134 pounds.
Miss Virginia.
Robin has green eyes, too. She's 22 years of age, 5'8" tall, and weighs 110 pounds.
Miss Texas.
Barbara's 21 years old, 5'6½" tall, and weighs 110 pounds. She's a brunette with blue-gray eyes.
Miss Utah.
Margo is 5'7" tall and weighs 120 pounds. Her hair is brown and her eyes are hazel.
Miss Pennsylvania.
Sandy is 22 years old, has light brown hair and green eyes again. At 5'6½" tall, she weighs 106 pounds.
Miss Hawaii.
Judy is 20 years old with blonde hair and blue eyes for a change. She weighs 130 pounds and is 5'9" tall.
Miss New Mexico.
Marlena's hair is brown and her eyes are green. She is 5'6½" tall, weighs 115 pounds, and she's 22 years old.
Miss Massachusetts.
A brunette with brown eyes, Diane stands 5'8" tall. She weighs 120 pounds and is 20 years of age.
Judges, take a good look at our 12 semifinalists in the official Miss USA swimsuit competition.
the semifinalists has her own special kind of beauty, and that's been true ever since they were infants. Let's look at these adorable baby pictures some of them brought us from home, okay? First is Miss Indiana. That's Jamie Beaker. And here's how she looks today. And we have Miss California, Donna Adrian. That's quite a change, isn't it? And I dearly love this one of Miss Virginia, Debbie Davis. Boy, what a difference 19 or 20 years can make. They sure were beautiful babies, and now they're really beautiful ladies. We'll be back in a moment, but first, here's a message from Cascade.
We have some very distinguished guests tonight, and I'd like to have you meet them. First, the senior senator from South Carolina, the Honorable Strom Thurmond. And the governor of the great state of South Carolina, the Honorable James B. Edwards. Here is the mayor of this beautiful city of Charleston, the Honorable Joseph P. Riley, Jr. We also have a visitor from Mexico, where the Miss Universe pageant will be held in July, the Deputy Secretary of Tourism for Mexico, Señor Manuel de Santiago. It's time for all of us, including the judges, to sit back and relax and enjoy a musical production that stars all 51 of this year's Miss USA candidates. It's not part of the competition, but the ladies have been rehearsing very hard, and I know you're going to enjoy it. They're wearing Celesta tuxedo outfits by David Howard of California, but they're here to prove that you're never fully dressed without a smile.
Brother,
seeing the country's prettiest and brightest young ladies. This year's beauties include, let me tell you, 29 brunettes, 21 blondes, one almost redhead. They range in height from a petite 5 feet 2 inches to a stately 5 feet 10 and a half inches tall. The youngest contestant will be 18 next month, and the oldest is a ripe old 25. But whether this year's Miss USA is a blonde or a brunette, tall or short, over 21 or under 21, I can promise you she'll be just as beautiful as her 26 gorgeous predecessors. And we will return right after this message about Downey.
Come on in, the feeling's fine.
Makes clothes smell April fresh as it softens them.
It smells terrific.
Downy Fabric Softener for that great downy feeling. Rinses April freshness and softness all through your clothes and helps rinse out static cling.
It doesn't cling.
Come on in, it's April fresh.
People really notice what Downy does for their clothes. The April fresh smell of Downy, a noticeable improvement.
Marcia Van Dyke never expected to be in an ivory commercial. She is because her boyfriend wrote and told us about her healthy-looking complexion.
To me, Marcia's as healthy-looking as any of those ivory girls on TV.
To keep my skin healthy-looking, I do stick to basics, like lots of soap and water. And I do use ivory. Because to me, skin doesn't need deodorants or heavy perfumes to stay healthy-looking. Skin needs gentle cleaning, like ivory gives.
If you know a healthy-looking ivory girl, write us. Maybe we'll make a commercial about her, too.
We ask some of the handsome men of the Citadel to add their talents to the Miss USA evening gown competition, and I am happy to say that they were eager to help out. In fact, they seem to enjoy rehearsing with the girls, and rehearsing, and rehearsing. They'd be rehearsing yet. To set the mood for our evening gown competition, here are the cadet members of the Citadel Chorales and Junior Sword Drill.
Yeah.
Massachusetts.
Debbie Shelton, Miss USA of 1970, and tonight she's your personal guide to one of Charleston's most interesting streets. Debbie.
Welcome to Church Street, which is appropriately named because it's the site of St. Philip's Episcopal Church, the mother church of the original colony of South Carolina. And this is the Dock Street Theater, the oldest theater of the United States. Right now, the Corallers Music Club is rehearsing a song from their concert version of Porgy and Bess. It ain't necessarily so. We could stay and watch, but we've got to get back to the pageant and Helen O'Connell.
Thank you, Debbie. We enjoyed your little tour very much. We'll return in a moment. First, let's hear from a woman who knows how to be young at any age.
The lucky lady who becomes Miss USA tonight will receive some fabulous cash awards and prizes. She'll win $10,000 in cash, a $10,000 personal appearance contract, a $3,500 Sarah Coventry cash scholarship, and much, much more. That's Kim Tomes, just a few seconds after she won the Miss USA title right here in the Gilliard Auditorium in Charleston a year ago. Kim's beautiful crown and the crown that's waiting for our new queen were designed especially for the Miss USA pageant by Sarah Coventry. Here's a part of a fashion collection by Patty O'Neill that our new queen will receive. Miss Universe is in a pleated one-piece dress. Miss USA is wearing an oriental floral print, both of Celanese 412 polyester. Tonight's winner will get a Vivitar 700 pocket flash camera with built-in electronic flash for sharp pictures and a Vivitar System 35 SLR camera outfit. And Miss USA will enjoy her own private paradise with this kidney-shaped swimming pool installed in her backyard from Polynesian Pools. This is historic Fort Moultrie. And look at this fabulous prize modeled by Kim Tomes, a natural black glamour ranch mink coat from the International Flemington Fur Company. For our winner from Arpasia, a wardrobe of young Edwardian dresses and organically grown sweaters, featuring these polished cotton dresses with flutter elbow sleeves, V-neck, and tie back. And you've got it, Miss USA. Great style, sensational features, true quality. You've got it, Miss USA. The Toyota Celica GT Liftback. And along with all of those gifts, our new Miss USA will compete in the Miss Universe pageant on Monday night, July 24th, in Acapulco, Mexico. Now, our judges have seen the 12 girls who still have a chance to win those prizes. They've judged them in swimsuits and in evening gowns, and now they're faced with the job of choosing five finalists. That's no easy task. So we're going to give them one more opportunity to see the unique facial beauty of each of the candidates. Get ready, panel, because here come the 12 Miss USA semifinalists for 1978. Miss Florida.
Who sets very high goals for herself and usually attains them. She's musical and very athletic.
Miss Indiana.
what makes her a creative person. She's also inquisitive and very good-natured.
Miss Alaska.
Miss Alaska's sign is Pisces. She loves to travel and is particularly good at making people feel comfortable and is uncomfortable, well, in uncomfortable situations. Who wouldn't be?
Miss Oklahoma.
Nancy's sign is Aries, and like so many others born under that sign, she's a natural leader, and she's loaded with energy.
Miss California.
Miss California considers herself very competitive, but she's her own worst critic. Like most Libras, she weighs all sides of an issue before making a decision.
Miss Virginia.
Robin is a Gemini, outgoing, considerate, and able to change moods easily and often. She likes to associate with creative people.
Miss Texas.
Barbara's sign is Pisces. As she told me, she's strong, but rather sensitive and hopelessly romantic. Well, there's nothing wrong with that.
Miss Utah.
Margot says she's dependable and well-organized and attributes those qualities to her sign, Leo. The things that make her happy are sunshine and looking good. Well, she ought to be happy.
Miss Pennsylvania.
Miss Pennsylvania is a Gemini with a great sense of humor. She's a very with-it young lady who loves clothes of all kinds.
Miss Hawaii.
She describes herself as inquisitive, enthusiastic, and athletic. And to that list, we will add beautiful.
Miss New Mexico.
Marlena is an Aquarian. As she tells us, she's easygoing and patient, and she proved it during a week of very exhausting rehearsals.
Miss Massachusetts.
Miss Massachusetts is a happy Libra who loves to be with other people, all except gossips. They turn her off. They turn us all off.
And these are the 12 semifinalists. In just a few moments, five of them will become finalists for the 1978 Miss USA title.
Auditorium in Charleston, a young lady from Texas captivated the audience every time she walked out there on that stage. And they weren't the only ones who thought she was a winner either. The judges agreed and named her Miss USA of 1977. And here she is with only a few moments left of her exciting reign, Kim Tomes. Hi, Kim.
Hi, how are you?
I'm fine. That's good. Every Miss USA does an enormous amount of traveling, but I understand you literally circled the globe, didn't you?
Yes, we were on a 50th anniversary with an airline, and we went around in 55 hours. We even broke the world's record.
I guess that would. Did you have any problems traveling around with all your wardrobe, that type of thing? Did that bother you?
Well, I have a funny story. One time I was traveling through Chicago Airport, and my bags went through security. The woman said, may I open your bags? And I said, sure. And she pulled out, do you remember my costume last year?
We all do, yes.
I had some six shooters that I brought along with me, and the lady pulled them out, and the police ran over, and everybody was in uproar. It was kind of embarrassing.
Furor. You're about to graduate from college, aren't you?
Yes, from Texas A&M. I'll return in the fall, and I'm really looking forward to going back.
I'll bet. And when your reign is over, in less than half an hour, mind you, is anything going to change drastically?
Yes, my weight. I think after this, at 12:01, I'm going to hit a junk food place.
Oh,
been
no.
Watching it all year.
Everybody's been watching your weight. Now, don't do that.
All right.
Thank you very much, Kim. I just know you're going to have as much success in the future as you've had all this year. We loved you. And now let's join a couple in an interesting dilemma over the use of her own secret antiperspirant.
Jan, where are my keys?
Where you put them last time.
Oh, brother, how am I going to find anything in all this stuff?
What?
Look, three hairbrushes, two antiperspirants. Why two?
I've got to have my secret.
Secret? Can't you use my spray?
Maybe that's okay for you, but I need something I know is strong.
That good, huh?
Uh-huh. Secret really helps keep me dry.
Well, if it's that strong, let me try it.
Secret is for women. Smell.
Hey, pretty. But as long as it's strong.
Sorry, hon.
Secret. Strong enough for a man, but made for a woman.
Well, Secret keeps you looking this good. I guess we've got room for it.
Oh.
But I still can't find my...
Keith.
When Anna Sandoval agreed to try our fluoride toothpaste, she didn't know it was Gleam.
I like it. It's terrific. It was really tingly. My mouth felt fresh. And when I rinsed it with cold water, it really felt great. This one seems to have everything that I want. Fluoride and the tingly sensation. What's the name of the toothpaste?
Are you ready?
Yes. Gleam! No kidding!
It has fluoride, the best cavity fighter you can buy. It also has a cool burst of freshness.
It's terrific. I really like it. It's really a good mouth quencher.
Try Gleam Fluoride Toothpaste. Find out what freshness can be.
Makes my mouth tingly and fresh.
Twelve beautiful ladies have come this far in the competition for the Miss USA crown, and five of them are about to move one giant step closer to that exciting goal. The judges have cast their ballots, the votes have been tabulated, and we're all going to learn the results right now. Mark Puritz, may I have the card, please? On this card are the names of the five finalists who still have a chance to become Miss USA of 1978. Good luck, girls. The first name on the list, Miss New Mexico. And look who's next, Miss Hawaii. And the girl with the sweet tooth, Miss Texas. That room is still scoring Miss Massachusetts. One more girl has a chance to become Miss USA, and that girl is Miss Indiana. Congratulations, ladies. One of you five lucky finalists will be the new Miss USA. Miss Hawaii reached over here and gave me a little pat, but actually, these five Miss USA finalists were chosen by the judges for their beauty, poise, and personality. And now you at home have one last chance to decide who you think should be Miss USA. I have a group of cards containing the names of our judges. I'm going to ask each of our finalists to pick a card, and I'll read the name on it. And that judge will ask her a question, and her answer should help you decide who should be the winner. Summer Bartholomew, will you please give Miss Hawaii the first choice? She reaches in. She pulls out the name of Barbara Peterson. Barbara Peterson, will you step to the microphone with your question, please?
I would like to ask Miss Hawaii, you know, as Miss USA, you do a lot of traveling throughout the world. But right now, if you were to take a vacation for 2 weeks, where do you think you would go, and what would you do?
Well, I would probably go to Honolulu and visit my family and friends and see how they are. I think it'd be great to see them since I would be traveling so much.
Very good, Miss Hawaii. Now over here to Massachusetts. And Massachusetts has chosen the name Leroy Neiman. Mr. Neiman, will you step to the microphone, please, with your question for Miss Massachusetts.
Aside from your mother, what contemporary woman would serve as a model for the kind of life you would like to lead, and why?
Well, the next best thing to my mother would be my grandmother. She's raised six children, and then my mother, of course, raised six children. She managed to keep a career and at the same time raise a beautiful family, and I hope I can follow in her footsteps.
Good. Miss Indiana. Your remark about your grandmother brings us back to Cookie. I wonder if there was a bingo game tonight. Do you suppose she's still watching? Miss Indiana has chosen Bo Svenson. Bo, would you please ask your question of Miss Indiana?
What kind of person would have a good chance of becoming your good friend?
A person who was graceful and truthful, gracious, understanding, and I think anybody has a chance of becoming my friend as long as I know I get to know something about that person.
Thank you, Miss Indiana. All right, sweet tooth. Miss Texas has chosen Alfred Allen Lewis.
If a computer dating service matched you up with the perfect date, what would he be like?
He would be honest, sensitive, good-looking, of course, and a nice person to be around.
Thank you, Miss Texas. Miss New Mexico. She has chosen Dong Kingman.
You know, if you enroll in a self-improvement course, you know, I figure you don't need improvement course. What about yourself you want to improve?
I think that I would like to take a role in patient.
Feel better, a handsome gentleman. And we have one who would love to sing a song just for them. Here he is, Jack Jones.
With one more look at you, I could learn to tame the clouds. Let the sun shine through. Leave a troubled past, and I might start anew. I'll solve the mysteries if you're the prize. Refresh these tired eyes. With one more look at you,
I learned to change this.
The young lady who is about to be named Miss USA will be one of more than 80 contestants from countries on 6 continents who will take part in the Miss Universe pageant. Now, this year, the new Miss Universe will be crowned in Acapulco, Mexico, Central America's most glamorous and popular fun and sun capital. Here's Acapulco, way down here on the west coast of Mexico, and parts of the show will also originate from here in Mexico City, from Guadalajara, and from several places over here in the Yucatan Peninsula, the site of some of the world's most breathtaking pyramids and archaeological ruins. Now here's a sketch of one of those settings for the Miss Universe pageant, designed by Don Shirley, our very talented art director. It's quite spectacular, isn't it? I think so. I think it's going to be a terrific pageant, too. And so does our beautiful reigning Miss Universe, Janelle Comisión.
Hi, honey.
Hi, how are you?
Well, I'm fine, but how are you?
Oh, I'm fine.
You've been an international celebrity since last July. Has that changed you in any way?
I don't think it has, but I must say I've been enjoying leading the celebrity life, and at times when I tend to overdo it, my sisters bring me back to reality.
You've been home, then?
Yes, I have. I've been home twice, a total of about 10 days, and I've enjoyed it a lot.
Have you been to Mexico yet?
Yes, I've been there twice, to Mexico City and Acapulco, and I'll be there the entire month of July preparing for the pageant.
Terrific. We're going to look forward to seeing you there, too. Thank you, Janelle. In just a few moments, we'll know which one of our 5 finalists will be going with us to Acapulco as Miss USA of 1978. Now, let's watch how a would-be football star tackles the laundry with all temperature cheer.
The judges have finished their work, the accountants have almost finished their work, and one of these 5 lovely finalists is about to be named the most beautiful girl in the USA. It happened to our reigning queen a year ago on this very same stage, and here she is for her traditional walk and to deliver her words of farewell. Miss USA of 1977, Kim Tones.
A year ago, I was a student at Texas A&M. I never dreamed of traveling to countries all over the world or seeing totally different ways of life with my own eyes. But what a difference a year makes, and what an exciting, educational, and wonderful year it's been. I want to thank Guy and Rex of El Paso, who helped make it all happen, and the people of the USA, who I've been so proud to represent.
Kim Tones, Miss USA of 1977. Now, may I have the card, please? The accountants have just given me a card with the judges' final decisions. Here, I have the names of the 4 runners-up and the new Miss USA. We'll begin with the 4th runner-up. The 4th runner-up is Miss New Mexico. The 3rd runner-up, Miss Indiana. The 2nd runner-up is Miss Texas. Both of you step right down here, please. Now, one of you is about to become Miss USA. The other will be the 1st runner-up. Very important position, because if Miss USA cannot serve for the full year, then the 1st runner-up inherits the crown. The 1st runner-up is Miss Massachusetts, Miss Hawaii, Miss USA. Go. Judy Anderson, former Miss Hawaii, now Miss USA. All of those prizes and cash awards and the beautiful Sarah Coventry crown are yours, Judy. and you'll represent the USA in the Miss Universe pageant in Acapulco, Mexico. And as your lovely predecessor, Kim Tomes, reads the Miss USA creed, will you please take your first official walk as Miss USA of 1978? Out you go.
We, the young women of the USA, believe people everywhere are seeking peace, tolerance, and mutual understanding. We pledge to spread this message in every way we can, wherever we go.
USA of 1978, Judy Anderson of Hawaii, Bob Barker saying good night, everybody.
And so from 51 lovely contestants, one emerges as Miss USA. And that one is from Hawaii, and she's wearing that crown right now, and it's proof that she's someone very special. She'll be competing in the Miss Universe pageant in Acapulco, Mexico, and you'll be able to see that. On behalf of all of us, thank you for joining us. Good night, y'all.
Miss USA Beauty Pageant has been brought to you by All Temperature Cheer, All Temperature, and by Gleam, the cavity fighter with a cool burst of freshness, and by Dry Formula Secret, strong enough for a man but made for a woman.
We won the music cheer tonight, and we're happy and proud to be here tonight with the luckiest girl of the year tonight, Miss USA.
Us Monday, July 24th, for the Miss Universe Beauty Pageant from Acapulco, Mexico.
Miss USA.
This is Jack Wells speaking.